Adam in San Antonio, Texas on 89.7 FM. You're up next on Catholic Answers Live. Hi, Adam.
Hi, how are y'all?
Doing great.
Thank you for having me. If you would, can you redefine your definition of what an atheist was again?
Sure. Yeah. My definition of atheism is either the claim that God does not exist or the claim there are no good reasons to believe God exists.
Okay. And would there be a difference in someone who says, I don't know?
Yes, I would say that is agnosticism.
Just plain out agnosticism. But what if you're, I suppose so. But if you support that there isn't a God based on the fact that you weren't given this knowledge, is that still just agnosticism?
Well, I think that is an incorrect inference. If you say there is no God because I haven't been given good reasons to think that God exists,
what if you, in your personal experience, are given more reasons to believe there isn't a God?
Oh, well, sure. If you think that when you look at the different reasons and you say there's more reasons to think God doesn't exist, then you come to the conclusion there is no God, then you would have reasons, you would have a case, you'd have a burden of proof, and someone would say, well, what are these reasons? Let's look at them. Do they work? Is that where you fall, or?
Yeah, I suppose what I'm saying is I wouldn't go as far as, I'll say I don't know, but most of my experience in my life tells me that most likely there is not a God, or at least not a God that is, you know, maybe possibly, if anything, the deist aspect of, you know, it's not interfering or having nothing to do with us.
Right. When you say a deist, you mean like the impersonal clockmaker God that makes the world, creates it, but doesn't really care about it or sustains it anymore.
Yeah, just kind of like made it, walked off, I suppose. Or, I mean, you know, I don't know. I don't categorize myself as any of these things. I just believe religion's unnecessary, and I don't think God's even necessary.
Well, let's go back to God then. What were some of the reasons then? Instead of being 50-50, it could be either way, I don't know. Something is pushed you, Adam, over the edge to probably what would those reasons be?
Well, I mean, I have traveled a lot of the world. I was a soldier. I was a combat medic. Mm-hmm. My personal experiences around the world, different cultures, those things specifically. So I was a Christian prior to serving my country.
Adam, it sounds like you witnessed evil acts. And by the way, thank you for your service. It takes a lot of courage to be a military medic, so thank you. Did you witness things that just seemed utterly incompatible with the creation of the universe by good God?
It seems to me that the idea of God is based on a perception of each individual, and it's entirely unnecessary. The things we would do on our own perception of what God is just seems to be based on man and his emotions rather than anything with God at all, if there was a God or is a God. You know, I mean, I suppose if there is a God, it's the sum of all things. But when I look at the things that interfere in my life, the sum of my things, the sum of my life, I don't know if I can even say this, but it kind of sucks. You know, I mean, the stuff I went through, I mean, I love my life today, but the things that got me here were not Christianity or God or, I mean, I have developed into a wonderful, amazing person who I can finally say I'm proud of. And I can actually say I have self-love, which I can't say I've ever had in my 32 years of life, but I wouldn't say a single thing that I've gone through as to develop as a person was based on God. I would say detachment from the idea of God has actually been what improved my life.
Adam, what's interesting, though, is did you come to a point where you said to yourself, you know, I don't deserve to be in this suffering I'm having right now or what I'm doing in my life, or maybe...
For a long time, I felt like I don't deserve, like, that there isn't a... I did grow up believing there is not a God because why would he make me suffer in this way? But I no longer believe that method.
But what's interesting, what you're saying is, oh, look, I pulled myself up from on my own army-issued bootstraps or what have you, and I've made myself a good and solid person. I've experienced change and progress and growth in life. I didn't need God. And I'll agree with you that people can access that inner goodness or that inner end they were made for if they don't have knowledge of God, for sure. There are people who don't believe in God who do really good things. But what's interesting to me, Adam, is that belief, I'm meant for more. I was supposed to do more, that I'm not fulfilled unless I reach a certain goal. To me, that is more harmonious with the idea that God created the universe and God made us and said, I made you And you didn't have to exist. It could have been another sperm, another egg. But I made you, made me for a certain end. And the fact that we know we're meant for more, I think that tunes into that God creation more so than just the accidental atheistic route. I don't know what you think.
I can appreciate that perception, but I tend to believe that, when you look at Darwin, he said, people tend to argue, what is it, they strongest survive or whatever, but they ignore the fact that he mentions many times love of the community, and love is mentioned far more times than the strongest will survive. So wouldn't that desire to better yourself and better the people around you, that why isn't that just what it is rather than a need to label it as God? Why isn't that just how it is? It's kind of like all the science, they'll say, yeah, you're labeling it with words and sure. terms, and those are great theories for right now, but everything's a theory because it's always temporary. It's always going to change.
Right, but
so
I think...
it's just words. I don't understand why we have to label it and say it's God.
Well, we use words to label the way the world is. We can't get away. We use words, but words signify a reality beyond them. And so we use arguments to figure out what kind of words we should use, what conclusions we should rely on. And I think that while evolutionary biology shows that loving one another has certain benefits, on the whole, as humans, unlike other animals, we don't think to ourselves, what do I need to do to survive? Or what can I do to optimize my survival and optimize my genetic progeny and siring, enough children, these things like that. Rather, as humans, we ask the question, how should I live? I should do what's right. There's a way I'm supposed to live that's not just about survival or genetic propagation, but about doing good and avoiding evil, about being good, being the way I'm supposed to be, having a proper function. And to me, evolution, it only does tell us how to function to survive and propagate, not to be more than a merely animal, to be meant for something in this kind of way. And this flows from an argument for God called the moral argument that I'm sure we may have other callers will bring up and I can talk about. Mm-hmm. But I do think that looked at in the sum total of things, even the bad things in the world, point towards a transcendent good that they deviate from.
And maybe it's a false dichotomy to say that the grace of God can't be operative in my own efforts to better myself.
Absolutely. Yeah. That even people who don't believe in God, God works through everyone, and he desires all men to be saved, so he can extend grace to anyone whom he pleases, and even those who don't know God may know him in an unknowing way on their spiritual journey.
Adam, thanks for your service, and I really appreciate your call. Please keep in touch.